Ladies and gentlemen, I've got some very bad news, and it pains me to have to break it to you. This is going to break the hearts of a few of you watching this, but video games are not movies. And movies are not video games. Now I know that, that may be difficult for some of you to comprehend, but it's absolutely true. The medium of video games is very different to the medium of film. It started a different way, it has a different method of enjoyment, and it just doesn't have the length of time and the growth that movies had. It developed in a completely different way, and as such, it's an absolutely distinct product. And as much as you may try and make video games fit in with your Hollywood ideals, or as much as you may wish you were making movies instead of games, you're gonna have to fucking suck it up, because games are games. Now, I've got here a Heavy Rain shoebox that was given out to reviewers just prior to the game's release in 2010. The box itself isn't very interesting, it's just got some origami crap in it, and I use it to store Aliens comics. But there is a press release inside that was used to help reviewers, you know, come up with buzzwords when describing the brilliant game. And I think it typifies this attitude that certain developers, have about Hollywood and games, and how games are completely inferior to film. Let me just pop this box down. I'll read out the bit that really pisses me off here. Here are the list of good points. We've got emotional experience.
Maybe if I told them I'm a lesbian.
Bending storylines. Accessibility, an auteur of video gaming, is what David Cage fucking calls himself.
Hey Bob, did you hear that?
But these two points are what really gets me. Hollywood production values, which implies that video games just aren't as impressive as anything Hollywood could cook up, and film quality narrative. Now, film quality narrative. Now, aside from the fact that with Heavy Rain that's just fucking untrue, let's focus on this idea that a video game's selling point is that its narrative is like a film. Now, I don't know about you, but I think video games can strive to be a little bit more than films, than this traditional beginning, middle, end storyline that we see in films most of the time. And I don't know about you, but I think that implies video games are not as good as films. And I think it does a complete fucking disservice to the nature of games if you say that films are better. And that's what that says. That says films have better stories. And looking at some of the films out there, that ain't fucking true most of the time.
You are tearing me apart, Lisa!
Now, it's not just David Cage. Good developers do it as well sometimes. Hideo Kojima has made no bones about the fact that he thinks of himself as some sort of film director when it comes to video games. He's often been called the Steven Spielberg of films. And again, I think this does some sort of disservice to games. After all, do people look at Steven Spielberg and call him, say, the Bertolt Brecht of film? No, because it's fucking stupid. You wouldn't do that. And it just implies that whatever medium comes after the last big thing is always going to be inferior.
He always told me I was inferior.
The point is, games are very different from film. They had a different start. When Nintendo resurrected the game industry after the crash in the 80s, you have to realise they started off as a playing card company and a toy manufacturer. And that's what games were at the time. They were toys. They weren't an artistic medium. They weren't an evolution of theatre and literature. And as such, they've had a more difficult time getting to a point where they're considered art. And we're very lucky, I think, to have games at the level they're at now, considering their humble and totally different start. And I don't think we're going to get video games accepted as a medium, if that's important to you, by following film. Because it's apples and oranges. They're two separate entities, and video games have to find their own way, and that's why we won't get this fucking Citizen Kane of gaming that everyone talks about. Just like fucking film doesn't have the war and peace of movies, and why anyone who would ask that question would be thought of, quite rightly, as a dick. Game developers and game writers who wish they were movie bloggers really should have a bit more respect for the industry, because it just puts the gaming industry down and puts it in the shadow of some greater entity in their minds, and implies that video games just aren't capable of doing what films can do, when I think Video games have the potential to be a superior narrative medium. I think the interactivity adds something that film just can't. And unless we're looking at that, unless we're looking at seeing what games can do as games on their own, rather than looking side to side at other industries and saying, how can we be more like them? I don't think we're ever going to grow this industry and help it evolve. Stop looking at fucking films, stop trying to be like Hollywood, and stop giving a shit about Roger Ebert. Simple as, really.